Good morning, guys. Well, I've got another problem here. This is a Briggs Stratton 20 horsepower V-twin motor in a L-120 lawn tractor, and the problem is, I believe, a misfire. It started first thing in the season. It's now with a crank no start. It would turn over fine, but wouldn't start. Quick start made it turn over transiently and then die, so I thought it was probably a fuel problem. So what I've done so far is I've replaced all of the fuel and I've replaced the fuel filter, and I managed to get it going. But just driving it around the garden here, I've got no power, and I've got some black smoke out the exhaust, and I've got what I think is a single cylinder misfire. I hope you come along as we make the diagnosis. So this is a V-twin engine. This is the first spark plug. The other one's on the other side. Here's the fuel rail and the fuel filter, and this is the valve cover. If this is a single cylinder misfire, then I'd like to know which cylinder it is. So I'm going to start with a power balance test. I'm going to try and start the engine, and then once it started, using gloves and insulated pliers, I'm going to pull off the spark plug and see if the engine quits. We'll repeat that on the other side as well to try and decide whether or not this is all coming from one cylinder. Let's see if we can get it started. Boy, that sounds pretty good. Activity on this cylinder. I'm going to go to the other side and do the same thing and see if the same thing happens. Well, that's pretty good, but I think the most telling thing about this is that the engine seems to be running a lot more smoothly now. Let's take it around the garden and see if it's working. So when I examine the engine, the only significant abnormality I'm finding is a little bit of oil discoloration around the left side of the valve cover gasket, and that's likely from a leaking valve cover gasket seal. But that doesn't explain our two problems of poor performance, poor engine power, and a little bit of bluish smoke, more than you'd expect with this. Now, what are our possibilities? Well, the blue smoke's been going on for a little while, and so this may be an unrelated issue. The first thing that comes to mind in a vehicle that's been sitting for so long is the issue as to whether or not there's some dirt in the carburetor that's affecting the amount of fuel that's going to each cylinder. If one cylinder is getting way too much fuel, we've got a problem. The second possibility is a bad plug. On the more serious side, if we've got a problem with valve clearance, tappet clearance, then that could certainly do this. And of course, bad rings and poor compression is in the order as well. So right now I've decided to pull the plugs and have a look at the plugs. This is a 5/8 socket. Boy, that wasn't very tight. It looks very black. This is the right-hand side. The gap looks fine, and the terminal itself looks fine as well. Do you see that? I don't see any evidence of tracking. The same on this side. A black plug. Terminal is fine. It's dirty here, but no tracking. I want to get at the magneto to turn off power to do a leak down test and a compression test. And so I'm going to take this cover off. These are 10 millimeter bolts. There are seven I'm going around. And then this one here, these are 8 millimeter bolts. Let's go ahead and do a cold compression test. I've hooked up my compression tester. I've grounded out the kill circuit of both magnetos, this one here and this one here, and I've unplugged the fuel shutoff solenoid. So now I'm going to turn it over. We're going to watch the compression tester to see what the compression is on the right cylinder. Okay, let's do the right side. I've hooked it up in the same way. I should mention that when you do this, you want to have the throttle wide open and the clutch wide open just to free flow of air. So turn it over again. $145, so quite a difference between the two. At this point, I decided to adjust the valve lash in case the weaker compression on the right was a valve issue. So here are the rockers here, and the first thing you notice is they're made out of sheet metal. It's really kind of cheap looking. And they both seem a little bit on the loose side. Now, this screw here, which is a T40 Torx, is the adjustment screw. And this one here, which is a 13 millimeter, is a locking nut. Now the ideal thickness is somewhere between 0.004 of an inch and 0.006. And I don't have an 004, but I have a 5, 7, and 8. So the 8 shouldn't go, and the 8 does go. So this looks to me like it's a little bit on the loose side. 5 goes, I would say, a little bit too easily, although it's a bit hard to say because it's kind of all loose, but let's just tighten that up a little bit. So we'll loosen off the locking nut. 5 goes easily, 8 won't go, 7 won't go. Perfect. Got a clean screwdriver. Put the screwdriver in. And I can feel the cylinder head right there. So in the owner's manual they say find top dead center and let it drop a quarter inch, which is interesting, right to there. So that's where we want to hold it. So now we'll take another big screwdriver and put that into the flywheel so the flywheel can't turn. So intake and exhaust. And 5. That's actually a little tight. And 8 doesn't go. So this side's a little tight on this one. Interestingly enough, 5 won't go. And this one, 5 goes easily. 7 won't go. So this bottom one is pretty close. Five goes, 7 won't go. That's good. 5 goes, 7 won't go. So we're good. All right, let's do a leak down test now that we've adjusted the valves. And the trick to this is to zero the reading on this gauge. I've got about 80 psi coming in here. That's turned down to about 10 psi here. And I've adjusted the adjustment to get it right on the zero mark, or as close as I can get it. And now I'll plug it into the cylinder. We're at top dead center. And so we've got about 30% cylinder leakage, which is in the green zone, fairly minimal leakage. The sound I'm hearing is mostly coming through the bottom part of the engine, so probably through the rings. I can hear it coming through the oil intake. Just listen to this. You hear that? But not much through the intake or the exhaust down here. So that's acceptable. Okay, let's measure the leak down on the right cylinder. I've got it at TDC with a screwdriver about a quarter inch beyond that. And here's our leak down tester, and I've just hooked it up with this fully out, and then you increase, tighten this up until that gauge gets to zero. Right about there. And then we'll hook it up. And that's actually fairly minimal leak down as well. So we're good on both sides. The cover gasket was leaking, so I've cleaned it off with a brake clean and a brass brush by hand. And now I'm just making a new gasket. this old leather punch isn't that great, but we'll see if it'll do the job for this here. Now I'm just going to cut around the inside. Okay, let's put it on. Well, after adjusting the valve lash, I went on to repeat the compression testing, and the numbers were improved, 125 on the right and 135 on the left, with better balance. But we still had that poor performance problem. Now, if you think about it, what we have is we've got an engine that seems to be running rich, with evidence to support that in the form of black plugs and blue exhaust, and a poor response to throttle. What would you do next? Now, out of respect for your time, I've decided to split this video into two parts, with the second part going into an inexpensive solution to getting this vehicle back onto the grass. I hope you stay tuned.